Did you know that God has given you to Jesus? In the 17th chapter of the book of John, Jesus is praying for his disciples. And verse 20 reveals that he was also praying for you. What a powerful promise this is. Long before you were born, long before you were a gleam in your mother's eye, you were on the heart and the mind of God. Numerous times in the 17th chapter of the book of John, Jesus prays for those the Father has given him. Listen as Jesus prays for you in verse 2. You gave the Son power over all people so that the Son could give eternal life to all those you gave him. Now listen to verse 6 as Jesus continues to pray. I showed what you are like to those you gave me from the world. They belong to you, and you gave them to me, and they have obeyed your teaching. Now listen to verse 9. I am praying for them. I am not praying for people in the world, but for those you gave me, because they are yours. Jesus continues praying in verse 24. Father, I want these people that you gave me to be with me where I am. Think about that, my friend. God finds you beautiful, precious, chosen, and priceless. And he's given you as a gift to his Son Jesus. That gift is called the church. The church is not a building. The church is you and me. And God is making something beautiful out of us. And one day he'll present us to his Son as a church without spot or wrinkle. You're not something to be thrown out or rejected and discarded. But because of Jesus, you have eternal worth, value, and purpose. So remember, you are a priceless treasure. Listen to Deuteronomy chapter 7, verse 6. For you are a holy people who belong to the Lord your God. Of all the people on the earth, the Lord your God has chosen you to be his own special treasure. Contrary to popular opinion, God is not mad at you. You're not a burden or an encumbrance or an affliction. You're not an irritation or an aggravation. You're not a problem child. You're not illegitimate, a mistake, or a mishap. You may have been a surprise to some, but you are not, nor have you ever been, a surprise to God. God has always been expecting you, and he has always been making plans for you. You're a gift that God is preparing for his Son. You're blessed of God, and you're a blessing to Jesus. And you have something wonderful to contribute to the world. You are the prize. After all, you're called the bride of Christ. And because of Jesus, you're not only acceptable, you're accepted in the Beloved. The Apostle Paul asks a great question in Romans chapter 8, verse 33. Who can bring an accusation against God's elect? It is God who justifies. You're a new creation in Christ Jesus, and no one can point a finger of judgment against you because you are made righteous through the blood of Jesus, just as if you never sinned. Praise God. What a powerful promise that is. You may not feel like a gift or a priceless treasure, but cast those negative feelings aside. In your mind, you must know that you are. And by faith, you must believe that you are who God says you are. You know, we hear a lot about detoxing our bodies of toxic air, water, and chemicals that can harm us. In the same way, you must detox your mind of negative words and worldly thoughts. Keep practicing the promises of God's word. Keep walking by faith, living a life that is pleasing to God. There's no better time than the present to shake off the guilt and the shame of the past and walk in the freedom of your brand new life in Christ Jesus. Let me drive my point home with this illustration. If I had a $50 bill that I wanted to give you, would you take it? I assume you would. If I crumpled it up and threw it on the ground and dragged it through the dirt and even said mean things about it, would you still take it? I assume that you still would. Why? Because you and I know that no matter how dirty or crumpled the $50 bill is, no matter where it's been, no matter what's been said about it, it still retains all of its value. The same thing is true of you, my friend. No matter what you've been through, no matter where you've been or what's been said about you, you are priceless in value, and that truth will never change. Your value is not established by other people. Your value is determined by God who made you. So don't live beneath your privilege and settle for an ordinary life of mediocrity. Jesus came so you could experience the rich and satisfying life, according to John 10:10. You matter to God. Your heart, your life, your plans, your story, it all matters to God. Let me challenge you today to live like that precious, priceless, gifted person that God already knows you are. So today, as we pray together, will you thank God for His transforming power that renews your mind and changes your heart so that you can agree with what God says about you? I want you to do this with me. Lift your hands. That's right. Lift your hands up to God and open your heart to receive a blessing from Him right now. Say this with confidence after me. I am treasured by God. Let's pray together. Sweet Father, the one I pray for right now may be weary and wounded by life, but I thank you that you are the mender of broken hearts. You're the repairer of shattered dreams. You bring hope to the hopeless. You give love to that one whose love tank is on empty. Will you remind them, Father? I know that you will. Remind them that your name is a strong tower and the righteous run into you and they are safe. Thank you for being our refuge, sweet Father. And it's in the mighty name of Jesus we pray and thank you. Amen.